everybody. Redneck and a Hat here. I'm back again with another gun video. One of the guys over at Two Mostly Bald Guys YouTube channel, Blake, he's a really good friend of mine. Well, they both are, Adam and Blake are, but anyway, Blake's got a Remington 12 gauge. It's a Mohawk 48. Anyway, he was telling me about it. He hadn't shot it in a long time. He's had it since he was a kid, and which is a long time, but anyway, he was saying that it needed really good cleaning, and this is the gun right here, but anyway, the stock was loose on it. I said, well, probably just need to be tightened up. Let me take it home. I'll take it apart, clean it, and see what I can do with it. So anyway, I brought it home, and I just got done cleaning it. It's nice and clean. It smells like gun oil. And the stock, I figured out why it was loose. It's looks like it's been dropped or something. But some of the wood across the top where it meets the metal is chipped off. That's what caused it to get loose. I took and tightened it the best I could. Other than maybe putting a shim in there somehow, I'm probably not going to get it any tighter. But I did get it cleaned. It was pretty dirty. And got it all lubed up. And it works nice now. But anyway, Blake, the Two Mostly Bald Guys, thanks for letting me bring your Remington home. This little 12 gauge is a nice gun. Anyway, it's chambered in 2 inch and 3/4. And like I said, it's a 12 gauge Mohawk 48. Get up here close to the camera. You can see it says Mohawk 48 on the side. There's the other side. Like I say, this is an older gun. I believe they made this gun between 1948 and 1959. They quit making it. Remington did bring it back into production like in the early 70s. I'm not for sure what year, but I'm pretty sure it was early 70s. And sold it probably through Sears, probably through the Sears catalog, maybe in the Sears stores, but they probably sold maybe couple hundred thousand of these guns, so they're not real expensive antiques now. This gun probably sold for $250 to maybe $300 brand new, and if it's in excellent shape, it'd probably bring about that now. If it had a ridge barrel, that would add on to the price too and make it worth a lot more, because they didn't make very many of these with ridge barrel, I don't believe. But this gun doesn't have the ribbed barrel. But anyway, this gun's a nice little 12 gauge. And thanks, Blake, Two Mostly Bald Guys, for letting me bring it home and giving it a little cleaning. Here's your plug for your all's channel right here. Pretty sweet on doing that, guys. So, by the way, go check out Adam and Blake over too, Mostly Bald Guys. They appreciate you watching their videos. They got some good videos too. A little different than mine, but a lot of truck and four-wheeler videos on there. Some how-tos, some Harley-Davidson videos. But go check their page out. You can check their page out over on the side of my page. It's in the featured, Two Mostly Bald Guys. Thanks, guys. a total rub down on everything, try to get some of the gun varnish and powder residue off of the inside, and then we'll kind of dry it up and lube it down. I'm just taking some of this bore cleaner, putting it on a patch, gun patch here, and I'm just gonna wipe everything down with it as best I can anyway. Okay, I pretty much wiped all of this down. One thing I need to tell you, when you if you decide to do a takedown like I just did by removing the butt, this end back here on this particular gun, it has this spring up in the tube here. When you take this out, it's spring loaded. It's gonna shoot across the room. So have both hands here when you take the little pin out. This little pin, it's not very big. Let the little pin fall out on the table and have both hands to catch this spring. There's a little wood dowel stuck in the one end. On the other end, it's got this little piece. And when you put this gun back together, this little piece goes all the way through the tube and sets right about in here. And then these two pieces have to slide up in side of here when you put that together. If you don't get both of these little arms in that hole, it's not going to work. You're going to have to pull it back apart. You're going to have to use needle nose probably to hold both of these and guide them as you slide this back in and slide these at the same time. But it's not going to work right because these are going to be jammed and it's not going to work. Anyway, I thought I'd mention that. Some guys, when they go put stuff back together, don't notice that they're not in this hole. So I'm going to get back to cleaning. I've got the trigger assembly out. I'm going to clean it while it's out. I'm going to touch the spring up and the dowel up. Might as well. It's out of the gun and it's really dirty from carbon and powder and probably some old grease. But anyway, I'm going to get back to cleaning. And I'm still cleaning. I haven't started greasing anything yet.
We'll be right back.
Okay, we've got everything pretty much wiped down and dried off. I'm gonna use some Outers gun oil, put it on a swab, and go to kind of getting a little oil on it now. I do the inside of the barrel after I clean it, just to help keep it from rusting. It may be a while before this gun gets shot. I am going to be using Outers gun oil, rust preventive main lubricant. That's all it is just gun oil. And I do use rim oil with Teflon, the spray. And I also use choke tube and gun grease. It's just a tube. And it's Outers also. But that usually lubes about anything up that I want to lube up on any of the guns. I'm just putting a light coating on it. If you get too much, you can always wipe some of it off. It's just to help help with rust, basically. And then I'll go to lubing the internal parts, like the trigger mechanism and action and all that. Alright, we've got the this part done with and lubed up. I've got to do down the tube, but I'll wipe the tube down real good here in the spring. Got everything on here. Now we're ready to start on the trigger housing. And after I wipe the trigger housing all down, then I'll go and I'll use some spray on it. Okay, got to wipe down fairly decent. Just gonna spray, not a lot, just a little bit to get it down in there. And when you spray it, you know, move the trigger. If you can get access to go down in towards the safety, you know, do the safety too. Makes everything work a lot easier, smoother. Nothing sticks, nothing hangs. And you kind of wipe the outside of it off if you get too much on there. I believe I've got everything pretty much lubed up. Wipe this down. So we're gonna put this back together now. I'm gonna take the spring. The metal end goes in first, the little wooden dowel goes in last, and slide it down, and you'll see it, slide this back a little bit, pull the arm out, and it pokes through right here. And that's what these two pieces, slide into that hole. So you have to take needle nose to hold them, lower them down in, and as you push this piece through, voila, they go in the hole. Now all you gotta do is push the little dowel in, and you'll have to line the hole up. Helps if you got a little bitty screwdriver. The pin goes in. All right. We're ready to put the stock back on. I found out why his was loose. Probably don't help, but his stock is cracked around here, and it's just loosened up because there was a little bit of wood missing. So I'll just have to tighten it down and see if it'll tighten down. Make sure these threads are clean. Slide the stock back on. Now, inside the stock, you got this washer and the nut, the screwdriver. It takes a big screwdriver to reach down in there. It's just a standard screwdriver to get that off. How I usually put this together, put the washer on the screwdriver the way I want it to go in. Turn the gun up, slide the screwdriver down in the hole while holding on to the washer up here, and put it on the end of the shaft, let that fall down in there, and did it go in. Nope, it didn't, it missed. Do it again. Time I got to go on. You have to do it a couple times. Then just pop your little nut down in there. Gotta shake it, get it on the hole. And I set the tube on the floor and stick the screwdriver down in there to get it started. Hold it with your knees or something. We'll be right back. have on there, whether it's just a plate or a pad, you can put it back on now. And it should be Phillips screws in there, by the way. It takes a small Phillips screwdriver. And you just stick it through the screw holes in the end of the pad, if that's what you've got is a pad. Before you put your trigger guard in, make sure it slides. Back together. Tightened it up the best I could. It's tighter than it was, but with some of the wood missing, it's chipped around the top up here. But anyway, it's like I said, it's tighter than what it was. It's shootable. Like I say, this is a Remington Mohawk 48 12 gauge. Shoots 2 3/4. Just a good squirrel gun, turkey gun. Anyway, glad you watched this video. Hope you liked it. Subscribe to my channel. That way you won't miss any future videos I put up like this. And I'm Redneck in a Hat. I'm out and I'll see you next time.